Hello student, in this lesson, let us do the problem number 2 on this chapter. So this problem is regarding the calculation of speed restriction on the main line of a railway track. Okay. Let us first read out the question and see what all is given to us. So it says a 6-degree curve branches off from a 3-degree main curve. So there is a main curve. This has the main curve degree is how much? 3 degrees. Now there is a branch curve which has a, so let us take this as theta b, which has a degree 6, right, in opposite direction. So we have seen these are in two opposite directions, right, in the layout of a broad gauge yard. So the gauge given to us is broad gauge in this particular question. Now it says if the speed of the branch line is restricted to 35 km/h. So the speed of branch line is given to us how much? 35 km/h. Because it is given in kilometers per hour, we have taken it as capital B. Now what we have to do, determine the speed restriction on the main line. So we have to find the speed restriction on the main line. Okay, assume permissible deficiency in CAT as 76. So E permissible is how much? 76 mm, or if you want to convert it into your centimeters, it will be 7.6 cm. Right. Now firstly, let us calculate the super elevation of the branch line. Super elevation of the branch line. Now what is the formula? For broad gauge, it is 1.315 capital V square by R, where capital V is what? Speed restriction in km/h, and R is what? The radius of the curve. Now we have a formula for R, which is equal to 1746.5 by theta. Theta is nothing but the degree of the curve. So in that case, if you substitute the values, what will happen? 1.315. V is how much to us given in km/h. So this should be substituted in km/h. Please remember this. So how much is it? 35 whole square by R is what? R is 1746.5 divided by theta. Now we are doing it for branch line. So theta for branch line is how much? 6 degrees. So 6. So on simplification, we will get the value as 5.534 centimeters. So if you substitute B in km/h and R in terms of degree, then you will get the value of super elevation in terms of centimeter. Now this is the super elevation for the branch line. Now we have to find the super elevation for the main line. Okay, so in order to do that, first we have to find the negative super elevation. Negative super elevation. The negative super elevation is nothing but the super elevation of branch line minus the permissible elevation, whatever is given to us. So super elevation of branch line is 5.534 minus the permissible is how much? 7.6. Now both are in centimeters, so we will get a value of minus 2.066 centimeters. So this is the negative super elevation. So the maximum super elevation that you can give to the main line is what? The maximum super elevation that can be given on main line is nothing but your 2.066 centimeters. However much is the negative super elevation, that much maximum you can give to the main line. But we have to calculate the speed for theoretical super elevation. For what? For the theoretical super elevation on main line. How will you do that? For this, you have to add up the maximum super elevation with the permissible super elevation. So maximum is 2.066 and permissible is how much? 7.66. So the theoretical super elevation what we get is 9.66 centimeters. Now using this super elevation, we can find the restricted speed on the main line. How do you do that? Same formula. But here what will we take? The super elevation of main line. This is nothing but the theoretical super elevation what we have calculated. Where is it? Here. So equal to 1.315 capital V square by R. So we know this value 9.666 is equal to 1.315. V is unknown to us if we have to calculate. So let me write this as Vm, that is the main line. Here this is what? Vb. Right, by R. R is how much? 1746.5 by theta. Now here the theta value is for the main line, which is 3 degrees. So this is an unknown for us. So on calculation, we will get this value as equal to 65.42 km/h. So this is the speed on the main line which we need. So speed restriction on the main line is 65.42 km/h. So this is the procedure on how you find the speed restrictions. Hope you understood the problem. Thank you.